We're going to be guarding our border with the military.
In April 2018, President Trump ordered 2,000 National Guard troops to the U.S.-Mexico border to aid Homeland Security. During a tour in October 2018, Border Patrol spokesman William Rogers complimented the California National Guard, who were working inside a Border Patrol station in San Diego, acting as dispatchers and monitoring cameras.
What's most important about it to us is the fact that prior to the National Guard soldiers filling these spots, we had to have sworn agents filling these spots.
Despite the kind words, some of these Guard troops working along the border in uniform may never meet the federal definition of a veteran. One of the things Guard troops need to qualify for VA benefits, like health care or the GI Bill, is to serve 180 days continuously on active duty. That means being requested by the federal government under specific circumstances, says Daniel Elkins, a special forces operator with a Guard unit in L.A. I reached him via Skype from the place in Utah where he's training to deploy overseas.
This affects many members of the National Guard. For example, currently, there's a federally declared border crisis that's going on.
Even though the president asked for the Guard and the federal government paid for the operation, their orders don't count toward being considered a veteran under federal law. Elkins also works with the Enlisted Association of National Guard United States, which is lobbying to bring greater parity between active duty and the Guard and Reserve troops, like making it easier for them to qualify to become veterans by letting them add up all the times they spend on federal orders instead of just serving 180 consecutive days.
Those should be added up, and when you meet that threshold, you should be considered a veteran and rate the same level of benefits and service as an active duty counterpart.
Most of the time, Guard troops are under the control of the governor, who can call them up to help with natural disasters like the wildfires in California. But there are a variety of missions. States like California also work with the U.S. Drug Enforcement Administration on counter-drug operations. Guard troops working in those missions can earn enough credit to be considered a veteran. Congressman Mike Levin, whose district covers parts of San Diego County, chairs a veteran subcommittee which recently held hearings on these parity issues.
We haven't followed a very basic principle, which is if you are expected to be doing the same sort of thing, putting your life on the line for whatever particular mission, I believe you ought to be able to get the same pay and benefits.
Levin says Congress has been slow to respond to the changing role of the Guard, which has been used more consistently since September 11, 2001.
The expectations and the demands placed on our National Guard and Reserves that perhaps weren't there previously, we have to make sure that federal policy reflects that.
Cost is a factor. More troops would qualify for federal benefits. Congress changed the law so anyone who retires from the Guard or Reserves after 20 years is officially a veteran. The law didn't allow them to qualify for federal benefits. Elkins, the Guard Special Forces operator preparing for deployment, says he's talked with former Guard troops who applied for benefits under the GI Bill after reporting to disasters like Hurricane Katrina on the Gulf Coast or Hurricane Maria in Puerto Rico.
They deploy, they're being told that they're being deployed, and they assume that they have the same level of benefits.
But they don't. He says that impacts retention in the Guard, but the consequences can run much deeper. Those federal benefits include long-term mental health care at the VA. The VA estimates how many veterans die per day from suicide. That grim statistic doesn't include the 919 suicides in 2017 among Guard and Reserve members who never achieved veteran status. The VA says that adds another 2.5 people a day to those who kill themselves, all former military, but not considered veterans. Steve Walsh, KPBS News.